Thank you for clicking on the video. Welcome back to the channel. This is another review for Good Girls Season 4, Episode 5, The Banker. I do apologize if y'all can hear the folk outside doing whatever they're doing, because they just decided today on this day at this time that we're going to cut grass. So here we go. Anyway, Beth is waiting for Rio. And it looks like she knows she's about to make a drop. She got her money there in her boxes. He's a no-show. And so she goes inside. She's been wired all that time. FBI girl and her partner, they like, you know, trying to wire her up, you know, to catch Rio in something. You know, they want to know what his deal is. They think that he's the boss of all of this. And so that's who they're trying to get. And they put a tracker on his car and everything. She like, he knows. He has to know. That's why he ain't show up. And the other guy's like, I mean, well, he might know, because the tracker just disabled. So he might know a little something. Oh, she worried. She is worried. And she should. She should. Ben and Nancy drop by to Annie's house. And Ben, I guess, I don't know if he was there to get something or what, but she flustered because she need a sitter. And Annie don't want Ben doing it, because Ben got class. You know, he got to go to school. And they thought about somebody. Oh, the daddy, he off at some convention, so he ain't even home. And he just, you know, okay, she volunteers, I'll do it. First, of course, they're skeptical, because everybody thinks that Annie is a child. So how can she watch a baby? She's a baby herself. But she's going to entrust her, you know, to do the job. And so she gives her, you know, the instructions and all of that. And, you know, Annie says she's down. She can do it. I got this. It's nothing. I've raised a kid before. I can do this. We see Ruby. She calls Stan, and she say, I'm over here. I'm headed to your job. I forgot to give you the sauce to your lunch. And he's like, oh, I don't need it. I already ate. And she's like, oh, okay. Well, he said that, I forgot what he said, but he was trying to give her all these excuses as to why he didn't want her popping up at the job, not knowing she was already at the job. And she knows that he's lying about where he is and what he's doing. So red flag for Ruby. Beth, she clearing out all the junk food in her cabinets. And Rio pops up. And listen, this scene here. Yes, God. Anyway, Rio, he comes in there. He puts the tracker on the table, because she gets ready to speak, and he's like, shh. He leaned back on the counter, and she's standing there like, what? And he, you know, he comes up, walks up to her, and unbuttons her shirt. And so, of course, he's looking for a wire. He unbuttons her shirt, so she's standing there in her bra. And then he gives her a look like, take that off, too. And so she takes the bra off. And then he's like, them panties, too. And so she takes her panties off, and I was like, yes, God. Yes, Beth. Get you a piece, Beth. Get you a piece, Beth. The scene was great, okay? The scene was great. He gets her down all the way naked. I mean, she was just standing in socks. And he tells her, better watch your back. Oh, that's so funny. Ruby is telling Beth, you know, the horror stories of what happened. Because, of course, now we got to talk about, she always got to run back and tell all the, you know, tell the rest of the girl, the rest. We'll tell Annie and Ruby, you know, what had happened with her and Rio. And she's telling her, you know, horror stories about, you know, what she's heard and what she's read about people who, you know, betray their drug dealer, who betray the plug, you know, who betray people in that sort of lifestyle. And she ain't helping. She ain't no help at all. But anyway, Annie come in there with that crying baby. Ruby get a baby a pacifier, and it works for a while. And then the baby don't want that no more. The baby crying some more. Then Rio's homeboy come in there, and he say the baby hungry. And they like, well, where you came from? He come in there to pick up Beth. Go on and get in the car. Of course, they're like, no. I mean, she ain't got to go. I mean, we can all go. Like, wherever the boss needs, whatever the boss needs today, she ain't gonna be able to do that. They, you know, throw the baby in there, you know, to, I guess, to guilt trip him. And so everybody's going. Dean, he gets a visit from the homie. The homie say he gonna get the $100,000 to get him out. Just you wait. I got you. Stan and his boss, they're at the bar, and the boss trying to get him the day drink. Trying to get him all liquored up, telling him he's good looking. And, you know, the next job, I guess, involves a single woman. And he want him to seal the deal with her. And Stan like, I'm married. I know you married. Your wife the one stole from you. Would you rather she be the one paying the debt? Stan would not like that. And so, that's that. Rio's partner, they back at the place. He's trying to put the car seat in the car. And Beth is like, it's probably easier to put it on the outside. He turned around like, are you on crack? And he says, she is not. She's not. He's like, the safest place in the car is the middle. That's a given. I don't know why Beth would say otherwise. Because they tell you that down at the hospital. Middle, rear-facing car seat. Anyway, they get to their destination and he gives her this bag and a gun and tells her she gonna need this. She go inside. It's a little creepy because at the same time we see somebody walking through and loading a gun and all of that. And I'm thinking, it's made to look like Beth is about to walk into a situation. And come to find out that's the homie about to rob a pawn shop. So he robbed the pawn shop so he can try to get this $100,000 and get the homie out. On the other end, though, when she tells the person that she's meeting that she's the banker, everybody, like, kind of scurries and runs to do what it is they're supposed to do, get the money. So, Beth, you know, she feeling her beat. We see a whole montage. She's going to this place, that place, this place, that place. I'm the banker. And on the last one, she's, give me the money, bitch. I'm the banker, bitch. That lady was like, so? The money? And the lady like, I ain't giving you my money. My mama, you want me to go to dialysis where my mama at and get it from them? Because that's what we on over here. You know, she's trying to throw that out there like Beth is supposed to care about any of that. Like, Beth is there to do a job as well. Take it up with Rio. I'm just here to get the money. I'm just the banker. Whatever your grievance is, with, you know, this deal that they have, or the fact that basically they, you know, being strong-armed, but still, still, it's not Beth's fault, it's not her problem, so don't give her all that, lady. Beth getting the car is probably short, but she get back in the car, you know, so they can move on. In the car, though, Annie is trying to make Ruby feel better because she feel like Stan cheating on her, like for real. The homie ain't, you know, Rio's partner, he ain't making it no better because he's like, listen, that man seeing ass and titties all day. Okay. Yeah, I'm sure most men working in a place like that can't wait to get home to their wives. Yep, if she putting it down like the strippers do. Don't do that. Don't do that. Everybody is out because they have to finish up when Beth gets back to the cars. You know, they got to go because Annie got to get back. Nancy done finished up early and, you know, she FaceTiming, so she got to get back. Everybody's back at home, you know, in their own respective places. Annie's home cleaning before Nancy comes. Ruby is at the house looking through Stan's clothes, looking through all of his stuff. She ends up finding this designer bag. Don't know where it came from. But that just adds more fuel. Beth, she's in her room staring at the gun in her purse. And then we see her pull back up on the lady on the last little place. And she pulls her gun. What you'll do if you got this in your face? What about now? You don't give me any money now? She ends up giving her the gun, though. You know, basically it's like protection. Like, if you think that you're going to be able to do what you just did to me, to anybody else, you need this. You're going to be needing this because you're trying to shortchange Rio. Yeah, you'll be needing this. She know him for his works, girl. You better listen. Nancy, she gets to Annie's house to pick up the baby. And when she changes him, she notices that he has a diaper rash. She goes off on Annie. It's like, girl, whatever. Next time, watch your own baby. If you going to be that mom, you know, micromanaging from your job, micromanaging, you know, from wherever you at, not with your own baby, then you could just watch your own baby. Seem to me that's what you need to do. Figure it out. Make some sacrifices. But you're not going to be on me all day. You're not doing that. She hollering, talking about some, why you ain't use the diaper rash cream. And he said, I did. She talking about which one. I mean, it's two of them in there. I didn't know which one to use. Well, one works and one doesn't. Girl, why you got some diaper rash cream in the bag that don't work? Why that's even in the bag? Why? See, it's that. No. Mm-mm. Watch your own baby. She really gives it to her and leaves Annie feeling like, you know, feeling like she's all irresponsible or whatever. No, Annie is, but still, don't do that. Don't do that. Beth, she's meeting with the Secret Service duo, and Rio pops up and sits down before they do. He like, you got something you want to tell me? And she's, you know, nervous, thinking that he knows. And he, of course, he does know. But he likes to play that cat and mouse game with her, make her feel like, make her feel like he about to, you know, bust her bubble on something. But then switches it up, and then it's something else. But he's definitely asking, you know, are you working with the feds? that's what he's trying to say. But he says something else. And you know. She tells him, hold on. Oh, she wants to know, you know, like, why her? Because he's basically had her out there, you know, at the forefront. And she's like, why does it have to be me? Like, can't we just both, you know, lay low? He's like, no, like, I mean, aren't you my girl? I mean, unless you're not. You're not my girl. So, you gonna be out front. I got to lay low, you know. And then he gonna tell her that his bosses want to meet with her. I jumped the gun, but that's... He does tell her that. I'm just gonna wrap up that scene. She ends up telling the Secret Service agents, you know, behind her once Rio leaves. Oh, he's got a boss. So, you know, that's that. Anyway. Ruby... She pouring up white liquor, like, to the brim, and Stan notices, and he, you know, is questioning her about it, whatever, and she just flat out, who is she? Because she pulls out this purse, you know, and she asks him, you know, like, who is she? And he's like, who are you? Stan, you don't get to ask those kind of questions. You don't get to play as if you've been honest and forthcoming, because you have not. You've been lying and hiding stuff. And, you know, being very evasive. So, you can't be coming back with, who are you? No. Are you cheating or not? Like, answer the question. You already got me questioning you because I'm finding bags around the house. You ain't gifted me with no bags. So, who's the bag for? Who's the bag for, Stan? It's like, can you blame Ruby for feeling any kind of way? Like, or am I crazy? Because that's the type of reaction I probably would have had myself. I'm coming up to your job and you ain't there, talking about you working, you lying. Like, that's the next thought. Okay, you must be doing something you ain't got no business, because why lie about where you are? Anyway, he ends up telling her, you know, what the deal is, and that, you know, basically he got to pay off the debt from them stealing. And, you know, you don't steal from that kind of man, so this is where we at. And she's like, well, how long? He's like, listen, how long you got to be in it with your guy? Until they say, you know, that they done. Or until they get arrested or something. We see Annie putting her clothes away. And Ben, you know, comes in there and kind of makes his mama feel better. You know, you a good mama. You do a good job. Don't even worry about it. Dean finally gets out on bail. He asks how she did it. That's when we see Beth and Rio having that other conversation. You know, about basically her being at the forefront and, you know, his boss is wanting to meet her. And so basically, I guess that little bit of information in finding out that there's Rio got a boss too, you know, that there's more information there. I think that was, you know, how he got out, because I'm sure the dude did not successfully rob that pawn shop, because we saw him sitting in the alley, almost in the fetal position crying. So Ain't no way he got that money. Ain't no way. Anyway, that was it. That was a quick little 15-minute review. Go me. Anyway, be sure to rate, comment, and subscribe to the channel. It's Call Me Busby, and I'll chat with you later. Peace and light.